WVU, West Virginia, dressed in white. They are the number 3 seed. Georgetown, the number 8 seed. Greg Monroe's been brilliant in leading the Hoyas to this point. Ed Corbett, Pat Driscoll, and Brian O'Connell are the officials. Fourth game in 4 days for Georgetown. Third game in 3 days for West Virginia. They were one of the top 4 seeds, so they had a double bye, and the Mountaineers controlled the tip.
Shot back down to Jay Billis. The Hoyas go.
And a design play, an errant pass as Ebanks tried to lob one up for Butler for a dunk. Then Butler teed up a long jumper that didn't go, and Bryant lost it in the lane. Austin Freeman, Georgetown's leading scorer for the year, just under 17 a game. In for Julian Vaughn in traffic. Too strong with the jump hook. Doris mentioned Daryl Bryant from the New York area, and he has struggled at home in this building. They played St. John's here during the regular season and the 2 games here in this Big East tournament, and Daryl Bryant is 2 for 19 from the floor. So he went out today with his mother and bought some new shoes, trying to change his luck.
Say some prayers. Well, of course, when they get point play, they're pretty solid.
Deshaun Butler had it rattle out, and then another rebound for Greg Monroe. He's averaged 18 points, more than 10 rebounds, and more than 5 assists in the 3 games that Georgetown has won to get to this point.
Well, Ethan Smith with the matchup, Jay, on Monroe.
Good defender, very athletic.
Chris Wright's been red hot. He's averaged a team-high 19 points in their 3 wins. They beat South Florida by 20 on Wednesday. Then they beat number 1 Syracuse, the regular season champs, ranked number 3 in the country, on Thursday by 7. And then they hammered Marquette by 23 last night. And good hands on defense by Freeman.
Anytime Monroe gets the ball, even if it's up a little bit higher, he's going to pass it off, and they come off those men up high very effectively for handoffs, or they can go back door. And Chris Wright is an outstanding shooter and very, very strong.
Wellington Smith missed a 3 for a big man. He can make that, almost 38% for the year from 3. It'll be Georgetown ball with 29 to shoot. John Thompson III says, my team is playing very well right now. Chris Wright says, when we're good, we can beat anybody in the country. His shot blocked by Wellington Smith. He also pointed out they can lose to anybody in the country. Georgetown has been up and down this year. They lost in the regular season to Rutgers.
Nice screen.
And Jason Clark swoops to the bucket.
Jason. The pieces have gotten better, Sean. That's what makes this team an improved one.
Well, even when they're trying to enter the ball to the elbow, they can still drive hard off that elbow. That was really well done by Jason Clark.
Clark's a sophomore from Arlington, Virginia, because Wright and Monroe in particular have been so outstanding. Clark hasn't gotten much attention here, but he's averaged 16 points per game in the 3 wins. Good spin to the baseline. And Kevin Jones was fouled by Greg Monroe, his first.
Now I'm taking this replay because you could never use your left. Jason, with the ability to blow by, man, and you're right. They use the center to dribble handoff for a slap back 3, dribble handoff, turn the corner, and you're right, that little screen, an explosion to the goal.
2 solid games here for Kevin Jones. Double points. Double figures in points in both of those games, despite the fact they were both low scoring. Bob Huggins, 75 wins in 3 years at his alma mater, and he's won 9 conference tournament championships. He's coached in 9 conference tournaments in different leagues. This is his 6th different league that he's coached in a conference tournament, 37-12 all time.
Automatic switching because of the size on the perimeter.
Austin Freeman short with a 3. And Deshaun Butler picked it off the floor. Bob Huggins also said before the game, imagine how good we'd be if we could make a shot. And he's still looking for his first field goal of the night.
Georgetown switching everything, even those little exchanges at the nail, the kind of curl screen that is very difficult to guard.
And Vaughn can contain anybody. The big guy moves the puppies beautifully.
Jason Clark called for his first foul.
Vaughn really did a nice job of moving his feet against Marquette, those quick guards.
Zone look here, huh?
2-3 zone out of bounds underneath. A lot of teams do that.
Yes, it may not be a bad idea, but on the long jumpers, you must rebound if you're Georgetown.
The out of the corner wouldn't go for Jones. Still no field goals for West Virginia.
Good job by Smith to get Monroe off that low block. Won't let him catch it where he wants to.
They do a great job fundamentally all over the floor.
But when they cut back door, you have got to stay low, turn your head, and keep that hand in a passing lane, because they throw it late and they throw it low. It's always a bounce pass.
Nice kick.
Monroe's open for three. Made one yesterday. Not tonight. Monroe has made only 7 threes all year. But the shot clock was running out.
It's all about Monroe, and sometimes it's his ability to set screens. This time it's Vaughn, but all these guys have improved. Speed to the 10.